The season of ordinary time is a time where we take all the truth we have learned from Advent, from Christmas, everything that we have learned from the other season, we take that and we assimilate that in our life. Amen? Hindi yung binabasa lang natin, hindi yung pinag-aaralan lang natin yung salita ng Diyos. Lahat ng tinuturo ng Panginoon sa atin ay dapat maging kabahagi ng buhay natin. We assimilate that. And then, as we assimilate His Word, sabi nga ni Bishop Dick, own His Word. Okay? Salita niya yan. But you take it, receive it by faith, and make it your own. Anong sinasabi ng Diyos? Yun din ang sasabihin ko. Yun din ang ipamumuhay ko. And ordinary time is a season that would teach us to take God's Word that we have learned, the truth that we have learned from the beginning of this year, and we make that a part of our life. Amen? So today, we have something very interesting in our gospel. But before we go to the gospel, to really understand the gospel, let us go to our first reading. Okay? Meron akong gustong makita yung scripture sa first reading natin. Then we go back to the gospel. Okay? And as we look at that scripture in the Old Testament, sa first reading natin, we will see the gospel in a different light. Maintindihan natin yung gospel, okay? Etong scripture natin, first reading, I would like to take the first verse of our first reading today in Deuteronomy 18, verse 15. Etong sinasabi dito, "The Lord your God will raise up for you a prophet like me from your midst. From your brethren, him you shall hear." Okay? Si Moses to nagsasalita. You know? Moses was the greatest of all the prophets. Remember, Moses speaks to God face to face. Okay? Pag nakakausap niya ang Diyos, face to face sila. God does not speak to him in dreams. God does not speak to him in visions. God speaks to him face to face. Amen? And I do not know how, paano nangyayari yan. But you see, here Moses is saying, a time will come, God will raise up another prophet like me. Kagaya ko, sabi ni Moses. Someone who speaks with God face to face. But the unique thing here, ang sabi ni Moses, you listen to him. Okay? Makinig kayo sa kanya. Now, if Moses is the greatest of the prophet, Moses could have said, you listen to me. Because I speak the word of God, I speak to God face to face, and everything that God tells me, I tell you, you listen to me. But take note, Moses said, a prophet will be raised up among your brothers. Okay? And he's going to be a prophet like me, kagaya ko siya. But you listen to him. Makinig kayo sa kanya. Okay? Now, we go now to the gospel. Tandaan niyo yung scripture na yon, ha? Sabi ni Lord, sabi ni Moses, God will raise up another prophet like me, but you listen to him. Makinig kayo sa kanya. Now, in the Gospels today, we find Jesus teaching in the synagogue. And there were scribes there. Okay? Nakinig yung mga scribes. Ano ba itong mga scribes? Scribes are the ones in charge of the Word of God, the Scriptures. Sila yung keepers ng Scriptures. You know? And they study the Scriptures. That's why if you want to know the Scriptures, if you want to understand the Scriptures, what God is saying, ang mga scribes ang expert dyan. They are like lawyers. You want to know the law, gusto mo malalaman, may nag-file ng kaso sa'yo, gusto mo malaman kung may laban ka ba, you get a lawyer. Diba? Someone who is an expert of the law. Sasabi ng lawyer mo, may laban ka dyan, wala kang kasalanan dyan. You know? And so, ganitong ginagawa ng mga tao doon sa time ni Jesus. They listen to the scribes. They would teach. And the scribes, when they teach, they will always say, para malakas yung dating ng sinasabi nila, etong sinabi ng teacher ko. Just like me. You know? Pag may sinabi ako, etong sinabi ni Bishop Dick sa akin. Oh, medyo malakas yung sinasabi ko. I would quote from my teacher. I will quote from my master. Okay? My mentor, si Bishop Dick. Kaya pag may sinasabi ako, you are blessed to be a blessing. Medyo hindi kayo convinced. Sabi ni Bishop Dick yan. Oh, amen. Okay? Yung mga scribes, they do that also. When they teach the law, they would say, according to Gamaliel, according to my teacher, and his teacher quoted from his teacher, yung teacher na yun, nag-quote din sa teacher, until they go back to Moses. Etong sinabi ni Moses, ayan, pag sinabi na ni Moses, tahimik na lahat. There is authority in what they teach and what they say kasi kinukuha nila kay Moses. Amen? Ganyan yung mga scribes. But one day when Jesus was teaching, nagulat yung mga tao and even the scribes, they were surprised. The scripture says that they were astonished. The word astonished means they were amazed. No? The son of a carpenter. Hindi nga siya nakapag-aral. No? He did not study. He was not taken into the wing of a great teacher. Okay? And here he comes in the synagogue. Sabi dito, when the Sabbath day came, he entered the synagogue and he started to teach. But everyone was amazed, astonished. Why? Because of the authority that he has when he speaks. Ang sabi ng mga tao, he speaks not like the scribes. Ano ba yung mga scribes pag nagturo? They only quote someone who is in authority. Sabi ni Moses, sabi ni Gamaliel, sabi ni Isaiah, they quote him. But when Jesus speaks, he speaks directly. Amen? Ito na yung sinasabi ni Moses. A prophet like me will come one day. He is going to be a mighty prophet. You listen to him, not to me, but to him. Why? Because Jesus is like no other prophet. Jesus is the Word of God Himself. When Jesus speaks, He speaks as God. Amen? Yung sinasabi ni Jesus, He has the authority. Yung authority ng sinasabi niya, the way He would teach, you know, hindi yung sa pagalingan ng teaching eh. Hindi yan sa pagalingan ng pag-deliver mo ng teaching mo. It is by the power and authority. Why would Jesus have that authority? Because He is the Word of God Himself. Ang lumalabas sa bibig ng Diyos, salita ng Diyos mismo, kasi siya Diyos mismo na nagsasalita. This is the reason why the scribes and the people are amazed and astonished every time Jesus would speak. They were astonished by His authority and power when He speaks, when He teaches. Okay? Then one day, nung nagtuturo siya dito at this time, there was a man with an evil spirit, unclean spirit. Ang unang demonyo na pinaalis ni Lord, saan nang galing? Ha? Sa loob ng simbahan. Okay? This is the first demon he encountered. He was in the synagogue. He was among the people of God. Ang unang, kauna-unahang demonyo na pinalayas ni Lord ay nandun sa simbahan. Hindi nyo man gusto marinig ito, pero minsan dito sa loob ng simbahan, ang daming demonyo. Pinapaaway tayo. Ginugulo ang buhay natin. That's why I always say, the most offensive place in the world is the church. Amen?
Ma-offend ka pag nasa simbahan ka. Why? Because there are demons in the church na ang assignment nila is always to offend you. Kaya pag may sinabi yung kapatid mo sa simbahan, oh, nasaktan ako. Masakit yung sinabi ni Brother Joseph sa akin. Hindi na ako tatabi sa kanya pag Linggo. Okay? Na-offend. Okay? We get offended by each other. Nagagalit. Minsan, aalis na lang sa simbahan. Hindi mo alam bakit umalis. Yung pala, nagalit sa'yo. Hindi niya masabi kasi sa'yo siya galit. Okay? And there was that demon in the synagogue while Jesus was speaking, while Jesus was teaching, and everyone was amazed because of the authority. Nakikita, he's not like the scribes when he teach. The scribes will quote the prophets. The scribes will quote their teacher. Jesus never does that. He speaks directly now at the present moment from his heart. Why? Because he is the very word of God himself. Then, nung dumabas tong demonyo na to, you know, and this is what the demon said. Let us alone. What have we to do with you, Jesus of Nazareth? Did you come to destroy us? I know who you are, the Holy One of God. You know, demons know Jesus. Alam nyo ba yan? Okay? They know Him. They really know who Jesus is. That's why this demon, when he spoke up, sabi niya, hayaan mo kami. You know, leave us alone. Let us stay here. I know who you are. The Holy One of God. They know Him. But Jesus rebuked him, saying, be quiet and come out of him. And when the unclean spirit had convulsed him and cried out with a loud voice, he came out of him. Demons are very obedient to Jesus. Sabi nga ng isang pare, alam mo, mas obedient pa yung demonyo kay Jesus kaysa tao. Minsan tao, makikipag-away pa sa Diyos eh. You know? The demons, when you command them, they obey. They obey. They know the power. That's why when Jesus commanded the demon to come out, na-surprise na naman yung mga tao. They were surprised because of the authority that comes with His word. His authority is not only felt. His authority is not only seen in this world, but even in the other world, even in the spiritual realm, the authority and power of Christ works. Kaya nagulat sila. When Christ speaks, earth is shaken, but not only earth, even heaven itself is shaken when Jesus speaks. Amen? The power and the authority, nandun yun. And why am I sharing this with you? Because this same power and authority has been given to His people, to us, when we speak the word of God. Amen? It's the same power. Pinapakita ni Lord that you can operate in the power and authority of God as a human being. That is why we need to take His word by faith. Ang problema sa atin, kinu-quote natin yung scriptures, wala namang pananampalataya. Okay? People just memorize the scriptures. They quote the scriptures. They speak the name of Jesus, but they don't believe in Jesus. Marami akong Kristiyanong kilala. Pag natatakot sila, in Jesus' name, in Jesus. They speak the name of Jesus out of fear. If you are going to speak the name of Jesus, if you are going to speak the word of God, you do it by faith, not by fear. Hindi sa takot. Amen? Jesus as a man He spoke the word of God with power and authority because he puts his faith 100% in what God says. Ganun din tayo. If we are going to go out in the mission, if we are going to bring out the gospel to the world, we have to do it with power and authority. Without the power and authority, and you preach the gospel, walang mangyayari sa'yo. Amen? We have to use our faith when you are sharing the word. And ito yung pag-aaralan natin, how are we going to speak with the authority of Christ? How are we going to speak with power? Well, we have to have faith in what we say. Kailangan natin, tayo mismo, we put our faith in what we are saying into the Word of God. Sometimes we just quote scriptures to people and it does not affect them. Why? Akala natin, pag kinote natin yung Bible, yan na yan. Bible yan eh. Bahala na si Lord yan. No. You have to speak the Word of God. You have to speak the name of Jesus with power and authority. And it comes by faith. It comes by faith. And this is what we need to learn. How do we do this? Well, if we're going to speak the Word of God by faith, we need to have the wisdom of God. We have to know how. Kaya sinasabi dun sa psalm reading natin, our psalm reading is also very important today. The beginning, ano yung sinasulat dun? The fear of the Lord is the beginning of wisdom. When you say the fear of the Lord is the beginning of wisdom, it means it's the very foundation of wisdom. Without the fear of the Lord, you can never operate in the wisdom of God. Amen. It is the foundation of the wisdom of God. You want to walk with the wisdom of God. You want to walk knowing how to have faith in the Word of God, knowing how to have faith in the name of Jesus, knowing how to speak in authority and power. It begins with the fear of the Lord. Starts here. Amen? Our second reading is very important, sinasabi ni Paul. You know, some people, they just go by their knowledge of the Word. Alam nang nila yung salita ng Diyos dito. That's why sinabi niya, knowledge, it puffs you up. Nagiging mayabang kayang. Kagaya ng mga Pharisees and scribes, they just study the scriptures. But they don't know how to live out the scriptures. Wisdom, according to my teacher, Bishop Ricardo, etong definition niya. Wisdom is the correct application of knowledge. When you have the knowledge of God's Word, it is not enough that you know about the Word of God. It is not enough that you read the Bible. It is not enough na binabasa mo yung Bible mo at alam mo kung anong sinasabi ng Bible. You need to have wisdom because wisdom would teach you how to correctly apply the Word of God. Tuturuan ka. Okay? Halimbawa, kakausapin ko si Brother Joel, tatanungin ko, Brother Joel, paano ba gumawa ng masarap na longganisa? Ano ba ang sikreto? Sasabihin ni Brother Joel sa akin, eto lang yung Father, kumuha ka ng prime cut na karne. And this is how you do it. I will have knowledge of that. Malalaman ko yan. Pwede ko pang isulat eh, kung paano ginagawa, anong ingredients, anong proportion. Pero pag ginawa ko na, ibang lasa. Okay? Hindi magpapareho yan. Why? Because even though I know I have information, I have knowledge how that food is processed, I don't have the wisdom to make it. Amen? Wisdom is the correct application of knowledge. We may acquire the knowledge of the scriptures. Maraming Kristiyano ngayon, maraming mga Kristiyano, alam nila ang Bible. They can even memorize the Bible. They know what the scripture is saying, but they never have the wisdom to apply it in their life. Hindi nila ina-apply. Kaya meron mga Kristiyano, 20 years na nakikinig sa salita ng Diyos. There are Christians who listen to the Word of God for 40 years and they never change. Hindi nagbabago ang buhay. Why? Why? Because they never apply. They never do what the Word says. Power and authority, when it comes to the Word of God, it comes when we listen. Now, tandaan nyo palagi, listening is not passive na nakaupo ka at nakikinig lang. When you say you listen, it means that you hear and you do. Kagaya ng nanay, pag sinabihan niya yung anak niya, to, paligos won. Ayroon nga, hindi magpaligos. Ano hambaron it, nanay? Kabati ka, did you hear what I said? Anong gusto ng nanay? Makinig lang yung bata? Hindi. Narinig mo, ngayon, gawin mo. That's why the word listen is two actions. To listen means you hear and you understand, then you do. Amen? Yan ang ibig sabihin yan. You hear and you do. Yan ang word na listen. That's why sinabi ni Moses Old Testament, sabi niya, a prophet like me will come, you listen to him. You hear him and you do what he tells you. That is where wisdom comes. When you listen to the Word of God, you hear the Word of God, then you do it, you begin to understand what God is saying. Understanding will lead you to wisdom. Maraming tao, alam nila yung Bible. Minsan nakikita ko nga, nagdidibati pa, nag-aaway sa Bible. When I was in high school, nung high school ako, nasa Bacolod kami. Nag-aaral ako sa Bacolod. Every afternoon, meron kaming classmate na magaling sa Bible. Pumupunta kami sa plaza, nakikipag-debate siya doon sa mga pastor. Merong isang lugar doon, tinatawag namin na Freedom Area. That is an area where you can speak your mind. Hindi ka huhulihin. Sabihin mong gusto mong sabihin sa lugar na yan. Doon nagkikita yung mga pastor, Baptist, Pentecostal, Adventist, lahat sila nandun at magdidebate sila paggalingan ng theology. Yung classmate ko is only high school but he's brilliant. Matalino talaga pagdating sa Bible. So sinasamahan namin siya. Magdidebate siya, mas matanda pa sa kanya. Meron siyang nakadebating matanda doon, haba ng bigote. Akala mo ermitanyo. Kalaban niya sa debate. They are debating on the scripture. Sa sobrang galit ng matanda, sabi niya sa classmate ko, bata ka pa, pilusopo ka na. Kinuha niya yung Bible niya at pinukpok doon sa classmate ko. You know? They're quoting scriptures. Sige, batuhan sila ng Bible, batuhan ng scriptures, ala, quote ng scriptures dito, quote ng scriptures doon, ang lalalim ng mga scriptures. I went there, hindi dahil sa scriptures, nandun ako dahil sa away. Nanunod ako ng away ng matanda, tsaka yung bata, tinitingnan ko, lumalaban talaga yung classmate ko. Pinukpok na lang siya ng Bible. You know? And sometimes we are like that. We take the Bible and we like to talk about the Bible. Nandito tayo sa loob ng simbahan, magkukwentuhan tayo tungkol sa salita ng Diyos. Etong tanong ko, ginagawa ba natin? Ginagawa ba natin? You know, we like to sit down. Christians like to sit down and talk about the Word of God. Alam mo, sabi ni Lord,
He will supply all our needs according to His riches. Oy, amen, brother. Amen. Talaga. Kwentuhan silang kwentuhan. Pero minsan, hindi naman ginagawa yan. Yung my God shall supply all my needs according to His riches and glory by Christ Jesus. How many of you know that scripture? You read the scriptures, the verses before that, it teaches us to give first. Basahin nyo yung mga verses. Bago yan, basahin nyo. Ang tinuturo dun, magbigay ka. You give sacrificially, you help others, then my God will supply all your needs. Yun ang ibig sabihin nun. Okay? Dapat may action. May ginagawa tayo. That's why the authority and the power of the word is released in your life every time you listen. And listening is two actions. You hear and you do. When that happens, you begin to understand what God is saying. Many people, they read the Bible, they get information from the Bible, but they never understand. Yung second reading natin, sabi niya, it's all about love. The Word of God is all about love. Okay? The fear of the Lord, how does it come in your life? It's the foundation of wisdom. The fear of the Lord happens in your life. It begins in your heart when you love God. When you love God, when you learn to love God, then the fear of the Lord happens. It begins in your life. Natatakot ka hindi dahil parusahan ka ng Diyos. Natatakot ka na saktan mo yung damdamin ng Diyos. Amen. If you love someone, kung meron kang taong mahal na mahal mo, nag-iingat ka sa salita mo, baka masaktan siya. Yan ang fear of the Lord. You look at our second reading sa Corinthians, it teaches about love. It's not about the knowledge of the law. Sabi niya, the knowledge of the law, the information you get of the law, it will just puff you up. It will just make you proud. Makikipagdebate ka lang. Magpapakitang gilas ka lang na marami kang alam sa Bible. But if you begin to understand what God is saying, it teaches you to love. And to love means to obey God. And this is where the fear of the Lord comes, in obeying the scriptures, in doing what God is telling us. You begin to understand the heart of God. When you understand the heart of God, you begin to move in wisdom. A wisdom that the world can never refute. Magkakaroon ka ng karunungan na hindi makikita sa ibang tao. And this wisdom will allow you to walk in power and authority. When your words and your actions become one, now your words become very powerful. Pag pinag-isa mo yung salita mo na kinuha mo sa Diyos, at yung kilos at gawa mo, pinag-isa mo yung salita at gawa mo, then your word becomes powerful. It becomes so powerful that even demonic entities cannot stand up against you. Yan ang kailangan natin if we're going to go out on mission. Hindi tayo puro dada ng dada lang, ganyan lang ng ganyan, quote-quote lang ng scriptures, Bible study lang, no? When we go out for outreach, when we go out into the world, hindi tayo lumalabas para mag-Bible study lang. We are going out to the world to change the lives of people. And we know that the gospel can do that. Amen? We know that the Word of God can change lives. It changed me. Binago ako ng salita ng Diyos. And if it can change me, it can change others. That is why we need to bring the Word of God out. But we don't bring it out with words only. We should bring it out with action in our life. And that action should come out from a heart of love. Amen? Yan lang yung ibig sabihin ng gospel natin today. So I challenge us, like Moses, ano sabi ni Moses? Someday, God will raise up a prophet among you who will speak my word. Listen to him. Okay? It begins with listening. Listening means hearing God and doing what God says. It will bring understanding. Once you understand the word of God, what happens? You now begin to walk in wisdom. With wisdom, you walk in power and authority.